Good morning everyone. Again welcome back to S2CS. So as you can see, today I'm going to discuss unlocked and digital signals. So if you're a new viewer to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and share the video as much as possible. So let's start with today's topic. Okay. So before beginning with analog and digital signals, you must understand what are signals. So I have taken two points which will make you clear what are signals in networking. A signal is an electrical or electromagnetic current that is used for carrying data from one device to another. So only keep in mind these three points, that is, signal is an electric current used for carrying data from one device to another. So you will always remember the term signal. Next, in other words, signals are electromagnetic impulses used to encode or transmit data. Sometimes you can say that signals are also used for encoding or transmitting data. I hope you are clear with the term signal. Next, there are two types of signals, as you are aware of, analog and digital signals. So we will see one by one what are analog signals with some examples, similarly goes to digital. Analog signal is a continuous signal which represents physical measurements. So what do you mean by continuous signal? This is the main point here. There will be a minimum and maximum value fixed. Okay. So analog signal will be taking any infinite values between this minimum and maximum range. Okay. Between this range, analog signal can take any infinite values. You can see in the graph also how it has been plotted. I hope you are clear with analog signal. Next, there are some facts about analog signals. Analog signals are represented by sine waves. As you have seen now in your graphs like this, okay, they are represented by sine waves. They use continuous range of values to represent information. Now I have made you understand what are continuous range of values. What do you mean by that? Next, analog signals record waveforms as they are. That means there is no sampling of information and then recording. Okay. It just records the waveforms as it receives. Next, subject to deterioration by noise during transmission. So while the transmission of data takes place from one device to another, there can be unwanted disturbance. Noise means unwanted disturbance during transmission. So that can occur in case of analog signals. Now examples are human voice, thermometer, old landline telephones, audio tapes, etc. I hope you can clear with these images. You can pause the video and go through these examples. Okay, the devices using analog signals. Next, digital signals. They are discrete time signals generated by digital modulation. Now here, there are no infinite values. They only take two states, that is on or off. That means one or zero. Now in the graph also you can see, okay, this is zero, this is one, this is zero, this is one. So only discrete time values it takes, that is zero and one, the binary values. I hope you have understood the difference between the analog and digital. Next, facts about digital signals. They are denoted by square waves. Okay, like this. You have seen in the graph itself. They are denoted by square waves. Whereas in analog, it was sine waves. Now, digital signals use discrete values to represent information. Now, I have explained you what you mean by discrete values. Technology. Digital signal samples analog waveforms into a limited set of numbers and records them. Here, they don't record the waveforms as it is. They first sample the waveforms into numbers and then they record. Data transmission can be noise immune without deterioration. Okay, digital signals are not prone to noise. They can be noise immune. Examples are computers, CDs, DVDs. Okay. See, you can see through the images also what are the examples of the devices using digital signals. I hope you are clear with this small video from my side. If you really liked it, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thank you for watching the video. I will meet you in my next video. Bye.